Sent into the void. Perhaps it's a mercy. Perhaps not. It's been a century since I've unleashed my full power. Show me how your passion burns.
Is this the best your world offers?
Tormented screams can be heard once more as the shadows recede from one of the burning figures.
You rabble couldn't kill time in a tavern, let alone me.
Goodbye for now, old friend. Stay dead if you can.
Faithful ally.
But it was not his doing. I would manage to give a robot some duties for her grandfather and grandfather. A chance thing of birth would be no match for my
children. Tormented screams can be heard once more as the shadows recede from one of the burning figures.
Nothing is more dangerous than a secret. I learned that a long time ago. So I ask you, what secrets do you have?
Can you finish the job?
You're close. Just speak to...
With the uttering of that last word, the story of Yawa and her companions is complete. It is a secret no more. You have broken Vecna's spell.
Wait. It's done. The pact is broken. I am Yara. Once again, I am free. Come, my friends. We are all that is left now. Let's make the best of it. As for you, adventurers, I doubt that Vecna is done with you. So best of luck.
What is this blasphemy? The speaking of secrets, the breaking of a covenant. Such insolence will not go unpunished. You were to destroy my palm, not free her.
The Master of the Hunt has created several challengers for what he calls his tournament. Once you are prepared, enter the arena. The Master of the Hunt nods to you from behind a barrier. Now that your group is assembled, the first of the hunters joins. Hunter Mori arrives in the arena. She bows, then whistles for her own hound.
Most competent hunters, bested by you. Truly, well, you've earned the respect. Abilities even further. The Duke will disappoint by losing his Griggs the Red Cap retreats into a room filled with deadly traps. He activates them as he begins to fight. Homer of Pixie vanishes on top of magic. This frigid air permeates the area. As Griggs falls, Homer takes a deep.
Center at the entrance.
The final challenge will be more exciting than I previously imagined.
Thank you.
Join them. Even as his wounds take a toll. Yes. This is what I was after. This singular moment. This life and death struggle. The pinnacle of the hunt.
The apex hound rises once more, shaking off its apparent death. Death is only temporary for the strongest hounds of the wild.
The glint of gold.
Delay them if you can, but they will always catch their mark. The master of the hunt staggers back, overwhelmed. Then he begins to...
What kind of hoard hides within this little chest? Hunt begins anew.
You have arrived at the Valley of the Door to Faraway. Ahead, Hawthorne and Hirsten argue from the relative safety of their respective circles of power. The barrier in the southeast fades.
That's the Hawthorne I once adored. Ooh, such a fire within those branches. And like any true hero, I won't be told what's best for my home. Yes! Show you it's doubtless fact that tearing down the Ladrin walls will usher freedom for us all. Nature's beauty and its truth, of course, informed by my worldview.
The corrupted unicorns vanish as if on cue. The archfey and the dryad pause. Hawthorne stands resolutely. Hearsome gives her a brief nod and a wink. She responds with a roll of her eyes.
Well played, dear Sprout. But the door yields to my will ever so slightly. Let's see what comes through.
At Hearsome's command, giant fiery insects pour out of the door to Faraway.
How brightly they burn.
Go forth, honored guest!
Stop them if you can, Hawthorne cries. But we must stay focused on the doorstones, or all is lost.
The barrier in the southwest fades. Contained the fire beetle swarm.
Sneaky. The tiny form cannot take this way. Breaks my glass.
Here's some pauses and tips. Hawthorne sways, obviously drained. Dark energies cling to her form.
Well, what's that I hear?
Another guest
knocking on the door.
What great beast approaches now, I wonder?
A monstrous furry beast leaps through the door with a loud pop.
Oh, don't you dare laugh at me, old flame. I can work with any clay I am given. Rodent! You will lust for the acorn no more. Instead, you'll only be sated by Eladrin blood. Now go forth and bite someone! Let us continue.
The barrier in the northeast fades.
Lamandias and dried lambs offered me the perfect man of wondrous offers you.
The vorpal chipmunk turns tail. It skitters back through the door to its home plane, somewhat the worse for wear. A loud roar echoes from the door. Pearsome and Hawthorne pause and turn toward the noise. The dryad's movements are labored. A gigantic bear peers out from the doorway. Pearsome cackles with glee.
Yes, 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 though. Shouldn't it be larger? Ah, well, never mind. Off you go, my pet.
The Archfey and the Dryad resume their
journey.
The barrier in the northwest fades.
I am the true hero. Once they've gone, the world will know. I am right, let nature flow.
The song stops yet again, as the last doorstone comes into balance.
Well done,
cries Hawthorne.
Rally to me so we can end this!
Roaring in pain, the gigantic bear flees back from where it came. An answering roar thrums distantly from beyond the threshold. Could that be its mother? The ground begins to tremble with the steady thump of footsteps coming from below. A Fomorian rips himself out of the ground, hatred blazing from its terrible eye. Hawthorne shudders and falls, maimed by the giant's attack.
And although we haven't enjoyed our tete-a-tete, but this breakout star deserves a solo performance. Stop! Take these punches. Can't say that. I'm sorry. Seeing you knocked to the ground. I knew that this would happen in this battle voice. What shall our great heroes do as you face certain doom? Will they grovel at my feet or stand defiant through and through? You claim I'm the villain. Well, you pray.
The Morian King bellows, continue raining down on him.
Sator, friends, aid me before these outlanders cut me to the quick!
Ah, cover, right. Oh, I'm sorry, my dear.
I need to finish this song.
Here's some.
The king shouts.
We were to end the Aladrin plague together as allies. Was I but a tool in your scheme?
Rather an... And I the one who turns his eyes.
But it benefits us both early. After all, the Aladrin will destroy.
The Florian's heart flames.
Treacherous goat. I curse you! Fancy yourself the master of song! Well, no longer shall you master a note!
Hearsome's tune suddenly turns sour. His fine fiddling is replaced with jarring discord. Panic seizes him.
What have you done? My fiddle! You broke it! No,
worse. You've stolen my musical prowess. It cannot be!
Now who's played who, Archfey?
Sneers the Fomorian king as he retreats, fading into shadow like a bad memory. Ska's herd follows, vanishing, leaving no other threat. Free of the Fomorian's gaze, Hawthorne rises, defiant.
Let me take the finale then,
she cries. Tried your best to down me, but darling, did you know that you could never fool me? You're not a hero! As the song's last note echoes through the valley, the wind blows. And the door to Faraway closes with a sigh. Victory is yours.
Chest. Now we may see the glint of gold. So ends our hunt. Begins anew. The hunt begins anew.
Do we have nothing? Yeah, the trap can. That's in a second.
Rushing through the fortress, you arrive at the inner sanctum of Sura. Devil General Shower, architect of the Inferno.
Barking a command. The horned devil sets his bodyguards upon him.
Arthur sinne kuten pidet ole.
What kind of hoard hides within this little chest?
Sorion addresses the group.
This place has changed quite a bit since my last visit. He begins. These islands around us are a new development. They seem to be held up by a network of skyhooks. That jet of air over there is an example. Perhaps, with a Featherfall enchantment, you could use the jets to explore. Once we've secured the chronoscope. Speaking of which, the chronoscope itself appears to be heavily warded.
On dark and tired wings, the architect of the situation flies down the green gate.
Poor Kazith the Mad? But she was slain!
Gasps Sarion. The Dracolich almost seems to grin as she responds.
And that would make you Sarion the Predictable, I presume? I wouldn't want to forget our proper titles, after all. Yes, I was slain. But death can be turned into an advantage if you know how.
You can't really be thinking of tinkering with the chronoscope,
begs Sarion.
Meddling with time itself? The risk! You can't predict what would happen!
Indeed. You are half right as usual, young one.
Korkaza chuckles as she flies off.
By the dragons above!
Sarion roars as he shifts into his original form.
The chronoscope is activating, cycling backwards. She means to change history. Find her and stop her.
Your role, vital as it is. For the world will only see my final draft, and not what was edited out. For creatures of such small size, and minds, you are nonetheless adept at battle. I truly respect you and the threat you represent. Now, catch me if you can!
The Dracolich lands on an island to the west and resumes her chant.
Korkaza!
Cries Sarion.
I still serve our kin. I still serve our Arganesen,
retorts the Dracolich.
You fear what you do not understand, young one. I must do this for all our sakes.
Before you stands a large mage-crafted furnace in dank surroundings. One of the sewers below Stormreach, perhaps?
You're not going to just leave me be, are you?
Asks Korkaza, her voice calm even in the thick of battle.
Of course, I've designed this. With the chronoscope, I can alter time itself. And with time on my side, I am unbeatable.
The damage you've dealt to the Dracolich suddenly vanishes.
It was easy enough to master reworking the last minute or ten. But of course you know I won't stop there. My next steps will require test subjects. And you all just volunteered.
Your kind are as fragile as new-laid eggs.
The
Another of those troublesome little devices.
As the last time rift stabilizes, the wards around the chronoscope flicker out. Okaza takes wing, positioning herself over the chronoscope. Sarion rises to meet her.
What is your answer? This is your last chance!
Cries Sarion. A chorus of wingbeats announces the arrival of more dragons. The Dracolich's jaws part in what might be con- Both dragons begin to cast spells. Sarion lands and calls you over.
This crisis has ended.
A chest. Now we may see the glint of gold.
I am Tovan DeCaneth.
Become.
If you know me at all, then you will understand that I merely intend to help the Warforged, nothing more. Please leave my workshop now. If you do not, there will be consequences. You are quick to kill the ones I've saved from their misery. No doubt your minds have been poisoned by Chana's lies. Still, you should be careful about the choices you make. Doubtless Chana told you that I am hurting the Warforged. Well, that is not true. I am merely cleansing them. Have you encountered the Lord of Blades? The Lord of Blades claims that the Warforged are superior. However, I have discovered a way to fix the Warforged. Much as I must refuse, I can't give up.
A dim image of Tovan stands in the middle of this room, surrounded by motionless constructs and odd-looking warforged. He beckons you to approach. Surprisingly complex in design. It must open something important.
to my personal testing facility. I'm afraid that we have no more time to debate my plans. Since you are so persistent, I will use my best creations. We'll take your measure first. Guards, attack them. I can see that I will have to try a bit harder. Deploy the sentinels and the heavy golems. While you're busy with those, I will prepare my next little trick.
Flashing lights appears above Tolkien. What could it mean? Your muscles spasm.
Behold, the purest canon crystals ever created. It's an arcane power source they have. Let me show you something.
Tovin concentrates and begins to weave a new arcane pattern. You've got to do something about those power crystals.
Blast you! Your stubbornness will ruin everything! It's time for me to end this. Prepare the Titans! dare say that these Warforged Titans are my masterpieces. I've put everything I know into these magnificent creations. If they choose, I may reconsider my position. My masterpieces! I must do something!
Tovin begins to channel energy into both Titans at once, putting him under incredible strain. His personal shield suddenly winks out. The Master Artificer is now vulnerable to a direct attack.
Fools! Understand what you've done? Do you want the Lord of Blades to slaughter this city?
By capturing Tovin, you have saved the Warforged from his mad plan to cleanse their souls. Channa de Caneth will be grateful that you have managed to protect House Caneth's reputation.
What kind of horde hides within this little chest? Yes.
You guys, thank you all. Have a great weekend.
So ends our hunt.